Danny's D-World, Abel, XAM, Michael Matt Killer, and the rest of the Dragon Ball protest team, and the Amazing Spider-Man and Sony Spider-Man support people. It's time for another new type of video intro, since I'm sick of recording videos at night so the video parts match. This is a new intro for an updated daytime intro, and this is the intro to various series of video responses to you guys. My first series of video responses were only going to be another rant on the Amazing Spider-Man's 1 and 2 made especially for you guys. And of course, Dragon Ball Evolution, Naruto, defense video, and of course, another Dragon Ball Z rant video aimed at each of you. I decided to add a rant on Broly haters. I'm a huge Broly fanboy, and I'm sick of haters hating on Broly for dumb reasons and asking dumb questions on why he's quote-unquote popular. So that, one for Dragon Ball GT, another for Goku versus Superman, and various other franchises I can't think of at the moment that you either like that I hate, or that you bash, or franchises I like that you bashed. So yeah, and also another video that I've been meaning to do for a long time but never got around to completing and finishing, and that is a brand new Wrestling Jesus style several reasons each of you suck your burial videos to finally bury it in this feud once and for all. So with that being said, let's get started. Gonna show you SOBs what I'm made of. Several numbers, whatever your name is, and the rest of the Dragon Ball protests, Dragon Ball fanboys and defenders. It's now time for the large narration portion. Several reasons Dragon Ball sucks. All of you, especially you, Abel, XAM, and Michael Matt Killer, you refuse to learn the lesson. You refuse to understand why Dragon Ball, the entire Dragon Ball series, sucks. And you continuously come back with reasons and excuses to prove why Dragon Ball doesn't suck and is not good for anything other than nostalgia when Dragon Ball sucks and there is nothing good or redeemable about it, and nostalgia is one of the only things it has going for it. So you guys, once again, like I said in the part one short, like I said in the original short narration version on my Dog 8798 channel, you guys probably will never you probably will never learn your lesson, but at least after this one you will be done, and you will never ever be able to try to appear before me trying to defend Dragon Ball again. So with that being said, several reasons, and already numbers 1, 2, and 3 are the Majin Buu Saga, Super and Cell. If it wasn't for these three sagas, or even just the first two, Majin Buu and Super, I would excuse every flaw, every nitpick, and every problem myself and a bunch of people have with Dragon Ball. Let's start off with the Majin Buu Saga, the Saga Killer. Prior to Majin Buu, even though Dragon Ball, in my opinion, still sucked before Majin Buu, the show was tolerable and exciting. And at one point, I was a huge fan prior to Majin Buu. This saga, apart from the fights, Fusion and Gohan's development and Mystic Kai ability transformation, whatever you want to call it, this saga was atrocious. Every character, excluding Gohan, Android 16, 17, PyCon, Olivo, and the Warriors of Death, and several supporting minor characters like Yajirobe and Korin the Cat, were ruined. Every character was ruined. No one was showcased good here. Not even Goku and Vegeta, who were two of the main characters and major players of this arc. Now I'm gonna save some of my rants on the Buu Saga for the actual Buu Saga rant. But we're gonna get the first two out of the way. I would excuse everything in Dragon Ball, even the crappy Buu Saga, if this piece of shit didn't take place right here. And that was number one, the Z Fighters not learning anything from the Cell arc, and just like the Cell arc, fumbling the ball on the easiest mission of all time, knowingly causing the release of Majin Buu, allowing him to destroy everything and everyone. They couldn't even save one person, and having the audacity, the unmitigated gall, to spam the Namekian Dragon Balls and use its power and the people power to defeat a being you knowingly hatched and unleashed, to defeat a being with their power instead of with your power, which you couldn't do. You couldn't do it with your power. This is not in any franchise except for these franchises right here, and each of these were far more exciting to play, watch, read, etc. than Dragon Ball. Each had a much better storyline, much better action, and a much better cast of characters you can actually get behind. Gohan, Tien, PyCon, Olivo, the Warriors of the Dead, and Android 16 and 17 are the only characters I can get behind. With everyone else, I cheer for Majin Buu. The best characters in Dragon Ball are number one, dead ones, followed by GT, supporting minor, and I guess alternate world characters and villains. Next. The other most offensive thing was going back to unleashing Majin Buu. You had the non-Saiyan characters, Krillin, Android 18, Master Roshi, Yamcha, and the rest, or Yamcha, Bulma, and Chi-Chi and the rest. These assholes had the audacity, when Majin Buu was wreaking havoc on Earth and everybody was living in fear and terror and had to deal with the threat of Majin Buu, these assholes had the audacity to take refuge on the lookout while Majin Buu was wreaking havoc on Earth. And then, while taking refuge on the lookout, you weren't doing anything useful or productive, such as training, and I don't know, making yourself, you're basically cannon fodder against Buu, making yourself useful cannon fodder against Buu, and doing what you were created to do to defend the Earth. You weren't special. Everyone had to deal with Majin Buu. And if you're too scared and too weak and wimpy to fight him, you pray, tough it out, and hide in the city like everyone else. You guys weren't special. The people with superpowers were hiding and stuff, but people like Hercule and the others who didn't have powers had to tough it out and hide in the city. And the funny part about it was, if everyone had hid in the city or had hid in their respective spots, they would not have been found and got killed by Majin Buu. So this makes them look even worse. They hid and they still all got found out and killed by Majin Buu. And had everyone been in their respective spots, Yamcha in the desert, Bulma at Capsule Corp, Chi-Chi and Ox King at Chi-Chi's place, Oolong, Krillin, Roshi, Android 18, and Marin, the island, Kami, House, had everyone been in their respective spots, Majin Buu probably would not have cared or locked on to each of your energies. But because you had all of these superpowers gathered together in one spot, that easily allowed Majin Buu, who quickly developed the ability to sense energies, to find each of you, and you stood by, and you allowed him to destroy and kill. You allowed him to destroy and kill the human race, because you were too cowardly to do anything. And then, despite that cowardice, you still got killed. All you did was prolong the inevitable. There was no situation where you come out alive against Buu, except the first one. I don't know, actually learning your lesson from the previous saga and doing everything to prevent Buu from coming out of that ball. But yeah, we don't do that. You don't attack Majin Buu. But you don't cower and allow the human race to die in your place, and you damn sure don't take refuge on the lookout, on the sacred lookout. While Majin Buu was doing it, and like I said, when they took refuge, they were eating, chillaxing, relaxing, and playing around while Majin Buu was wreaking havoc on Earth. After that, there is no coming back from that. And watch this, the next franchise, Super, is trying to remind you. They recognize how trash this was. Super is trying to remind us, the next one, which, if I didn't hate Dragon Ball Z after Majin Buu, I hate it. I still hate Buu Saga more, but Dragon Ball Super, that's even worse. And in the Tournament of Power, they're trying to remind us how awesome and how badass characters like Krillin, Android 18, Roshi, they're trying to remind us how badass they used to be back when those characters, remember when those characters used to do stuff? Sorry, this is my last memory of you. You guys taking the easy way out and hiding on the lookout and still getting found and still getting killed by Majin, and still getting found and killed by Majin Buu. They're trying to remind us, oh man, these characters were badass. Where was all this power? Where was all this bravado in the Majin Buu saga? They couldn't bother to get inside the hyperbolic time chamber, train and make themselves useful cannon fodder against Majin Buu, and develop and amount a defense force around the Earth until the real fighters, the Saiyans, get there and take care of Majin Buu. They couldn't do that, but they can train in the Tournament of Power and fight beings in the Tournament of Power like Jiren, Hit, who are stronger than Majin Buu. Plot hole. Once again, where was all that bravado and where was all that power in the previous sagas? Yeah, Master Roshi. It was announced that they announced, even though he retired in the Piccolo Jr. side, that somehow he was secretly training. So his regular island training is comparable to the god, to the Kamiya Popo, King Kai god gravity training, and the gravity spaceship training, and the greatest training, the hyperbolic time chamber training. What else? Then super. So that was the crappy turtle of power. Then the spamming the balls in the Buu saga. It's a plot hole here. Not only was there no repercussions for misuse of power, since GT hasn't happened yet, there's been no consequences for misuse of power. This leads to another plot hole in Tournament of Power. Zeno wants to get rid of the weaker universes. So why did he allow Universe 7 to contend? If you gotta use the Dragon Balls and the people's power to defeat Buu and can't beat him with your own power, that is the pure definition of pussy and weak. And they should have been erased. They should have been erased right there and let the remaining universe duke it out. Then the biggest one, Dragon Ball Z Resurrection F. If I didn't hate Dragon Ball Z already after Buu Saga, I disowned him after this. This movie right here, this was offensive. This was highly offensive. It was already bad enough in the previous one, Battle of Gods, which I think also sucks. But at least that was at least somewhat, that was okay. It wasn't good, it wasn't bad, but that was at least okay. But I'm a biased hater, so Battle of Gods sucks. But this was even more offensive. But it was already offensive that in Battle of Gods, they had the audacity in the post-Cell and post-Buu saga to have Frieza to be a topic of anything, to be a topic of any discussion in the post-Cell and Buu era. And this one did it even worse. Not only was he a topic, they had the audacity to bring this character back in the post-Cell and Buu saga. I want to save some for the actual super rant. So let me get to the part. So I'm going to skip this part and get to the next next part with Frieza. They not only had the audacity to bring him back, but somehow him training with a weak Frieza soldier gave him a power level higher than all the Super Saiyans from 1 all the way to 3 and Gohan's Kai ability form when he couldn't even touch 1. And he did it off screen, training with a Frieza soldier, and somehow achieved the gold form of his own and was able to withstand and survive an assault from Super Saiyan Blue and Red. Another reason I can't stand Dragon Ball, this superpower bargain cell, which is a pun on Vegeta's Super Saiyan bargain cell when he saw Kid Trunks turn Super Saiyan. This is the superpower bargain cell, which they've been doing since Dragon Ball. Characters like Krillin and Yamcha mastered the Kamehameha Wave, Destructo Disc, and Spirit Ball. Destructo Disc is the most powerful attack, all off screen. We saw no scenes of them training with Ki. GT and even Dragon Ball Evolution had training sequences where they showed you how the characters did they showed the training and the setup to the big budget CGI moves they were able to do later. So then Goku. The most laughable and offensive thing, Goku, the super strong Goku, apparently can't see a laser, can't sense, detect, or block, or take a laser from a weak Frieza soldier. This right here, I don't care which version you showed me, both of them are laughable, and nothing about this was sad. This was laughable and bad. This was laughable, bad, and offensive. And if I didn't hate Dragon Ball already, I hate it even more now. So, And everyone's saying, oh, well, you're hating Dragon Ball Z because of one to two sagas and series. Not only were these sagas and series canon, they were your climax. They were your end game. They were everything you built up to. And they undo anything that was achieved before this. So stop going back to number 3. the Cell Saga, which also sucks now. For a while, this was the best saga. This was the last one to feature or try to use the Dragon Ball Z characters. But I read the manga version, and I appreciate what Toei tried to do for the non-Saiyan characters, like Yamcha, Tien, Piccolo, and even Krillin. They tried to add more scenes with them in the anime to make it seem like they were actually involved in the Cell Saga, when in actuality, they weren't. You can remove some of these characters from the plot. Let's start off with one of the worst characters in the Cell Saga, Krillin. He didn't do anything. His whole purpose here was to set him up with Android 18. That's not story. That's not development. Danny's D-World. That is taking a useless character. That is taking a useless character who's outlived his usefulness to the series. The peak of Krillin's career was the Namek Saga. Him getting the Dragon Balls together, wishing back their friends, and dying to get Goku to Super Saiyan. After that, he should have left the series. The fact that he was in this saga is a plot hole. After what happened to him in the Frieza Saga, why didn't they bring him back to the Android Saga? In a fight that he is not only destined to lose, but destined to die in. And his whole purpose there, he didn't do anything. His whole purpose was to set him up with Android 18. That's not development. That's using Android 18 as a plot device to keep Krillin relevant, to keep Krillin relevant to the story. When his relevancy to the story has ended, his run in the series has ended. So plot holes and plot device. And his badass scene with Cell, which I thought for a while was a dream, because I haven't watched it since about 2001 when it aired. But Krillin's fight with Imperfect Cell never happened, where he actually damaged Imperfect Cell. If Krillin encountered Imperfect Cell and none of the other Z Fighters, especially the top of tier, were there to chase off Cell, Krillin would have died. They had more scenes with Tien, including Tien, I think, helping Piccolo track down Cell, making it seem like Tien was involved with the plot when once again he wasn't. Piccolo in the actual story would never allow someone human and low level, and no offense, yet weak, like Tien to tag along with him, where he'll be a liability. And then his iconic fight, which this was canon, Tien's iconic fight with Cell, where he held him in place. Yeah, that didn't mean a damn thing, because Vegeta and Krillin allow Cell to absorb Android 18 later. And Android 18, even though she had Tien and all these people fighting for her and giving her time to escape, she still got absorbed. So all Tien did was prolong the inevitable. You could have removed him from the plot and it would not have been any different. Cell would have still got his hands on Android 18 and became perfect. So, what's his name? And Yamcha too. His last useful act, one of my favorite moments, was recognizing his uselessness and carrying Goku off. But I mentioned the disgrace with Dr. Gero, an old man who's never trained a day in his life, somehow equipping himself with cybernetics, gives him the ability to easily grab and suck Yamcha dry. Yamcha, who trained with Kami and Popo and King Kai. Those are not Super Saiyan gods, but those are god levels, which means no one on Earth is on his level. And guess what? Just like with Frieza's power and Krillin's power, it happened all off-screen. More off-screen BS. Another reason I can't stand Dragon Ball. Fakery and bullshit and unoriginality. In every other franchise, there's an explanation to why he or she can do what he or she can do, or why he or she is that damn powerful. Dragon Ball, there wasn't. People like Vegeta and Goku jumped from a weak 18, 24, 33,000 to 530,000 in Frieza's first form. And I mentioned the stupid plot where he told him to transform, dooming himself and everyone. And he obtained Super Saiyan Blue. They didn't explain at all how he obtained Super Saiyan Blue. He got it merely because his fangirls and fanboys wanted it. Sorry, we work for power here. We don't get powers and power-ups and levels because we're a popular character, man. Or our fanboys and fangirls develop it. We work trained power or the Western way, scientific or fantastic accident. That's how we achieve power here. Next, Goku learned Super Saiyan 3. And he jumped from 180,000 to somewhere close to somewhere near Frieza, who was over 1 million. When he was 180,000, he's not even a match for Frieza's first form, and he lost, and all he did was fight Ginyu, get his body stolen by Ginyu, get his butt kicked by Gohan, Krillin, and Vegeta, and Vegeta healed in Frieza's tank, and that somehow made him powerful and pushed him over the edge and made him a match for Frieza. And all of his planet busting power, none of the characters, now I'll save that for later. Cell Saga. Garbage. One thing I'm sick of with you people. See, you know how bad Majin Buu and Super was, and how none of my points can be countered. None of mine or anyone's criticisms or points of these sagas can be countered and stuff. See, you like to come back to this Cell Saga. Back when the show was decent. Wasn't so bad. Cell Saga's even worse than Majin Buu. It's slightly better because it has a better cast of characters. And as much as I hate their climax was still better than Boo's, because at least it was their own power that finished off Cell. And they waited till after the battle to spam the Dragon Balls. And they saved a good number of people first, whereas in the Boo saga, couldn't save one. But other than that, it's even worse. At least the characters in Boo were believable. This was so terrible, Toriyama's editor told him to add Cell. Toriyama was gonna have Android 19 and 20, a fat man and a geezer, be the threat that kills off the Z Fighters for good. And then the guy told him to change it. He didn't add the androids, which that was better, but still, how is that a threat to the Z Fighters? And finally, Cell. So the Cell, the savior of this saga. But yeah, that's still garbage. So yeah, stop coming back here. Next is, like I said, useless characters. If they had kept storylines featuring this Dragon Ball Z team and the non-Saiyan characters, I would be more respectful and more appreciative towards Dragon Ball, or at least retire these characters, which is what the Cell Saga was supposed to do. Retire these characters instead of constantly bringing them in to be cannon fodder and food for the bad guy, literally. And it was literally that for Majin Buu. Nobody likes to see characters get washed, and no one likes Yamcha's characters like that. Characters like Yamcha's and Krillin's. When you have characters like those two, I like Yamcha, I don't like Krillin. When you have characters like Yamcha and Krillin, you either train and improve them, or you slowly and slowly phase them out of the series. If we had to get rid of the non-Saiyan characters, pussies like Krillin, Roshi, Bulma, Chi-Chi, Android 18, Launch, and them needed to get the hell off of my TV. You reintroduce all those characters, including Videl, just to get old and literally be cannon fodder and food for Majin Buu later on. But according to Danny's D World, nah, we were doing it justice. Reintroducing and introducing all these characters for the first time, or for the first time in a while, to get old, to get killed, to be cannon fodder for Majin Buu. Next, going back to the fakery and bullshit, the power scaling. the power scaling, the original Dragon Ball. In Dragon Ball, everyone was Earth level. They were 10, 100s, and 1000s. Somehow, later in the Namek Saga, later around the Frieza portion of the Namek Saga, everyone is hundred thousands, and later millions, with no one, and has planet busting and cosmic level power, with no one in Dragon Ball demonstrated that level of power. The most powerful attack in Dragon Ball can destroy a city and can destroy a moon, and destroying a city, a moon, and destroying a planet, which is much larger in width, length, and diameter, is not the same thing. Yeah, the whole destroying planets has always been plot holes and bullshit and more fakery and bullshit. Unless you're strong enough, like the Man of Steel, Superman, to move the planet or literally punch the planet or cut it in half, or you have a giant ray gun like a Death Star, or you have the Infinity Gauntlet with Infinity Stones or the Green Lantern super-powered ring, you are not destroying any planet. It should be like Naruto, when they force a juice, it should be death or extreme exhaustion from a huge chakra or ki drainage every time they try to blow up a planet. This just goes to show you, yeah, that crappy Dragon Ball Journey to the West, Bruce Lee, Jackie Chan, martial arts-esque comedy adventure, yeah, that wasn't selling. They had to become like every other franchise at the time and our stuff. They had to become more bigger, stronger, edgier, and more intergalactic, like our Western comics and various other animes and mangas which were around at that time. Dragon Ball was around long before some of these, but they were nowhere near fast-paced action, big, strong, and edgy yet. Unoriginality. And everything they've borrowed from, they've disgraced in their own franchise. And modern franchises like Naruto and Bleach took those same ideas and did them right. Then you're gonna come here, XAM, with the whole unoriginality. I was gonna save this for the Toriyama rant, but let's talk about it here again, and I'll repeat it in the Toriyama rant. Yeah, shut up with Dragon Ball's influence on modern series. Whenever you own and beat a Dragon Ball fan, they always respond with two arguments. Number one is the money and popularity, which is the pure definition of moron, sheep, hypocrite, and tool, and any other offensive name I've called you. Then the other one, oh, the influence on modern series. So since the modern shows, which their writers actually tried, actually cared about what they were writing, but since Dragon Ball helped inspire them, and a lot of those guys grew up watching Dragon Ball, oh, that makes Dragon Ball good too, because Dragon Ball helped inspire them. No, it doesn't. Plenty of people can be inspired by anything, and people can be inspired by something that was terrible. And that's the case with Dragon. That's the case with Dragon Ball. You want to go back to the Dragon Ball's time period, the Fist of the North Star, Saint Seiya, Ronin Warriors, Shirato, Dragon Quest, Yu Yu Hakusho, Sailor Moon, era, they were terrible. Then you want to come to the modern eras of Naruto, Bleach, Blue Dragon, Shinzo, One Punch Man, My Heroes Academia, and Hunter x Hunter, which was also in that, so that was in both decades. That was in both time periods. But the modern, we have even more awesome shonen shows. They suck. Just because you inspire something doesn't make you good. And like I said, Dragon Ball borrowed from all of those things. You're gonna come here and we'll see. Well, Star Wars wasn't original, so that means Star Wars is a class. That means, and Star Wars is considered a classic. Star Wars and Dragon Ball both suck now, but at least Star Wars during its day, but at least Star Wars was was actually good during the original, and even the prequel trilogy was good, was top. It's just that everything else is so much better nowadays that Star Wars is just kind of lame. And the new sequel trilogy, is some of the worst and most laziest and uninspired crap ever. But guess what? XM, Star Wars and Dragon Ball Z have something in common. Both franchises now suck. Both are long past their prime, and both only exist and offer nothing of value to a modern audience except nostalgia. Yeah, so get out of here with Star Wars. But at least Star Wars, during this time period, was good. Whereas Dragon Ball, since their inception, has always been mediocre, and they get worse and worse with each saga and each product they put out. So, and going back to multiple things went into the development of Naruto, not just Dragon Ball. You actually read the editorials, or actually paid attention to these shows, and did your research, you would know that. But I'll save that for the Toriyama rant. Yeah, except the show is garbage. It was garbage back then, in its prime and heyday, and it's even worse now, several years past its prime. And Toriyama's the worst writer of all time. I talk a lot about everyone involved with Dragon Ball, but everyone in Dragon Ball is okay. It's just Toriyama. Toriyama sucks and can't write to save his life. And also, Toriyama had editors helping him write Dragon Ball. A lot of the stuff in Dragon Ball was not his idea, even though he's credited the most. So, yeah, he really doesn't deserve respect. He had editors helping him write. And even when editors helping him write, that's the best he could do. So that's even more shame. So, what else? And, oh yes, the final reason Dragon Ball. The final reason Dragon Ball sucks. And that is, you can see by the picture here, Death Battle, three times. The third one wasn't an actual Death Battle production though, but Superman, Thor, and Martian Manhunter serving the Z Warriors, Goku, Vegeta, and Piccolo, their asses, and handing their butts on a silver platter. Now, what is the significance of these three DC characters beating these three Z fighters? For years, we had to hear from you guys how great the Dragon Ball Z franchise was, because their characters were stronger. Even though in debates with Naruto, Bleach, and other franchises, that's not what we're talking about. And that was not what we're talking about. The overpowered characters, it made the non-Saiyan characters, and even other Saiyan characters like Gohan, completely useless. So that's not a pro, but we're not talking about power. We were talking about story and development, but you guys kept going back to power. Well, finally, they're the DC characters who can make these Dragon Ball characters, these overpowered Marisu Dragon Ball characters, look like what they are. I just said, overpowered Marisu, and make these guys look like Krillin, and these guys look like Yamcha. Ooh, each one was pathetic. And Death Battle, they were some biased Dragon Ball Z fans. Everyone likes to say they were biased towards Dragon. They were biased towards had a biased hatred towards Dragon Ball. Not true. They were some biased DBZ fans because they did everything in their power. They did it to make these Z fighters look good. These Z fighters look good against these characters. They had a moment where there was kryptonite with Goku and Superman. There was kryptonite affecting Superman and Goku in a Goku character moment. Remove the kryptonite from the fight for a fair fight. Dude, Goku would not last that long against Superman for the kryptonite. He's not that strong or durable. He didn't win no categories. You would think Goku had the edge in martial arts and ki. Not even what's his name. And despite being a biased Superman fan, before I actually watched the conclusion of Death Battle, I chose Goku, even though I'm a biased Superman fan and a biased Goku hater. Then you got Thor and Vegeta, with Vegeta lasting longest against Thor. And then you got Martian Manhunter serving Piccolo up his butt. Love Piccolo, but dude, he sucks. Like I said, wimpy Yoda and wimpy Martian Manhunter. If the lore of Piccolo from Dragon Ball Evolution is Captain, is Red Skull, the Skrull from Captain Marvel, the mask, and multiple other things, your Piccolo from the anime is a wimpy ass Yoda, wimpy ass Martian Manhunter. He started off okay, but later, Ye got what you call it, with the worst one being Resurrection F, where he couldn't even beat weak Frieza soldiers. So after seeing how powerful the Marvel and DC characters are, the Planet Busters and Marvel and DC, who are even higher than Planet Busting, seeing how powerful they are, why would I go back to Dragon Ball Z? Seeing how powerful they are, with a much better storyline and a much better cast of characters and much better action, why would I go back to Dragon Ball Z with less exciting action sequences, overpowered Marigari Su characters with some of the worst storylines in history? So that is the final reason Dragon Ball Z sucks. You want to say, oh, these are some non-canon death battles. Their canon fights were even worse. So this was my long seven reasons Dragon Ball Z sucks, and a short introduction to other rants on you guys and Dragon Ball Z. If you still want to call me names like Naruto for liking Naruto, Dragon Ball Evolution, and many more than Dragon Ball Z, you're once again a dumbass sheep, an easily entertained moron and kid. I am not an easily entertained moron like you. You like Dragon Ball Super, where, like I said, Frieza, who couldn't even beat Super Saiyan, they had the audacity to bring him back in the post-Cell and Majin Buu era, and who, in off-screen training with a Frieza soldier, he was able to attain a power source higher than all the levels of Super Saiyan, including a golden form of himself when he couldn't even touch Super Saiyan. And Goku got owned by a weak laser. Apparently Goku can't see, dodge, take, or block a freaking laser. I double dog anyone to tell me Dragon Ball is a good franchise after something like that. After something so stupid, humiliating, and shameful. I double dog dare you. Yeah, like I said, we like us Narutards, Dragon Ball Evolution people, movie snobs, anime snobs, whatever. We like quality over quantity. Super Saiyan fight scenes and all the other stuff associated with Dragon Ball no longer oppresses us. We like quality over quantity. We are not dumbass, easily entertained moron sheep and kids like you are. So yeah, with that being said, I'm finished for now. Let me hit my music and get out of here. Can't take another lifelong drive.
down, down.